you like anime? Do you like Japanese-inspired things? Do you like clothes? I'm sure you like to stay warm. Well, I got this stuff for you. Introducing Imori.com, a website that introduces anime and Japanese-inspired styled clothing made in-house. And you can use the code Uchi15 to save yourself 15% off of all these cool, dope hats, beanies, hoodies, t-shirts, sweatpants, and way more where that came from. That's Uchi15 at checkout to save yourself 15% off your entire order at Imori.com. Yeah, what's up, everybody? It's your boy, Uch. I'm with the homie, Kai. And we are back again. Once again, how y'all doing today? What's going on, everyone? It's your boy, Uch. I don't know why I do my intro twice.
I just wanted, like, hey. I just wanted you to know that I went full in right there. I did the headbang and everything.
Have to. Yeah, you have to. Episode 16, Full Power Podcast. We in here, like, you know.
Having a good time.
Yeah. We literally, to warm our vocals up, we just had a nice lengthy discussion about Demon Slayer.
And, yeah, you know, something we can actually talk about safely.
Well, safely, well, in loosely, like, because, for your regard, yeah.
Excuse me.
Yeah, because I just recently caught up with the manga. At the time of this recording, this is literally right as the last chapter is about to become available this coming weekend. So I did the same thing with the anime. I pretty much binged the anime right as the last episode was about to air. So I don't know why I did that. I guess it was more or less to be, like, you know, with the shits and to, like, be, you know, feeling included and all that crap, you know, like, oh, like, I want to know what's going on, and this is hype anyway, so. But yeah, Demon Slayer hype is real, guys, just to put it plainly and simple.
Facts.
I completely 100% understand why Japan was, it's not even that they were acting over, if they were over-exaggerating it or anything. They were acting fiending. Appropriately. Right. They were fiending. I mean, I won't go on record saying that I totally condone, like, robbery, because that's definitely not okay. But
that is a form of fiending.
Yeah, that is definitely a form of fiending. Yeah, that's over fiending, I suppose, right? Like, talk about full power out of control. Those motherfuckers, man, oh shit. I don't know what the hell happened to Japan, but, like, you think I've been there.
When,
like,
when the manga is so good, it sets off the whole country's balance.
dude, that's so true, man. Like, damn. I've been there, like, 3 times. I've seen how the people operate. Everything's very well structured and organized and formal and respectable. I mean, yeah, I did have a couple, like, awkward run-ins with, not even a run-in, but, like, I was around some pretty interesting anime type moments that you literally would see in an anime, but you know, that's a story for another time. If I might have shared this on my stream, but we could talk about it later, I guess. But yeah, dude, like, hearing that they, like, people, it's not just to the point where, like, you know, obviously everything will go sold out or there was a shortage, but it got to the point where people were stealing the fucking volumes, and now it's like you have to request a volume of Demon Slayer at the register of whatever bookstore before, like, they don't display it anymore. You have to ask, and that is insane. Yeah. That's a level of success that, dude, like, I don't think Dragon Ball has that problem. I really don't. Hello? I honestly don't, but good on Gotouge. Whoa, excuse me. Really good on Gotouge. Congrats. Demon Slayer is a success, huge success. It is on its climactic finish. This weekend, if you have not read it, I definitely highly recommend it. Yeah, I hope that it's not for, you know, the sake of, you know, having things, you know, run a little longer. But I have said this, and I guess I'll say this again for the podcast's sake. I have a formula as to how to to healthily create something as godlike as whatever, right? And to give yourself time to rest while also making the demand even higher. And it's as simple as, like, taking time off And even if you have like a definitive end planned out, you know, we've seen it in the past, you know, with Dragon Ball in itself, with Naruto, and even with Bleach, there's always a way. And oh, and recently Inuyasha, I don't know if you heard, but Inuyasha's getting a sequel now. Through it's kind of like low-key on some Avatar Korra shit where it's not Inuyasha as the main character.
Pause everything. No. I don't think so. I'm sorry. How much Avatar The Last Airbender have you seen?
Oh, so Last Airbender. So when I watched it on Nickelodeon, I saw a lot of the beginning, and then I saw a bunch of the mixed middle, and then I saw the end, like on TV.
All right. Follow up question. What you know about Korra?
Absolutely.
That's nothing. Where you got me fucked up.
Well, I will say though, about Korra, I feel okay. So
you like, it's so like, how could you not? Like, it's so good that like, it's impossible to sleep on.
Well, I will say, like, I do want to give it a fair chance, like I do anything else that I have even the slightest interest in.
It is top tier. That show, well, everything about that show is top fucking tier.
All right. Well, I'll give it a shot eventually.
The
but
fillers
like,
are top tier.
But I have to, honestly, I feel like I'd have to actually rewatch Last Airbender first, like Avatar
fine.
Last Airbender.
If you do it like that, you will feel so much more like complete. I don't even know how to describe it. Like, it's just, it is what it
I
is.
Mean,
it's amazing. It's.
I will. I will say that like it's. I've heard a lot of mixed things about Korra though. To be honest. I've heard a lot of good, and then I've heard some very interestingly bad.
No. Let me put that shit to rest for you right now, right? You know, yo guys, unanimous opinion. Korra's lit.
Unanimous.
No questions. No subjugation. No. Nothing. Fuck your opinions. We're talking facts. Korra is lit. The show. The person. Lit.
Well, all right. Well, I'll remember this.
Forget, literally forget anybody that told you anything bad about The Legend of Korra does not know their shit.
Okay. Well,
I could put that shit to bed anytime.
Okay. All right. Well, like I always emphasize this on all of my platforms, the best way to gain anything is to experience it yourself. So
that is that's the best advice possible.
Yeah.
You need to experience it for yourself and you will not be disappointed.
Yeah, at the end of the day, we all gotta definitely, you know, be able to formulate our own opinions and not like let the masses convince us otherwise or to stir us in the wrong way. But yeah, like what I was saying before, like it's definitely possible to see anything get any kind of sequel because depending on how old or not it is, you know, nostalgia always sells, right? And even if it's something relatively new, like Demon Slayer is not that old. Like Demon Slayer is probably a few years old. Yeah. I think the manga. Let me pull this
up real
quick.
People trying to shit on Demon Slayer too. I bet you it's the same core haters. Get out of here, all y'all. Get out of here. Leave the chat.
He said leave the chat. But yes, okay, so yeah, wow, so the Demon Slayer manga started 4 years ago and it's about to end.
Oh, damn.
It's about to end this weekend. So it started February 15, 2016 and the end date is May 17, 2020, and so yeah, that's a 4-year run. The anime only just got its adaptation last year with the movie coming out this year, and obviously we're supposed to be getting a how do you call that, we're gonna get season 2 presumably following this year in 2021. But
who knows
yeah so
now?
I bring I, yeah, I bring all this up because obviously, as long as something is popular enough, and if the demand is there, then there's always a chance for some kind of sequel, some kind of iteration. Whether, and I know that there's people out there that they like an ending to a story. They like having like a beginning, middle, end, no matter how long or how short it might be, but as long as it's good. But the thing is, in the world that we live in, where there is such a thing called what is it? Demand, and it's like it's something in demand. It's like
supply and demand.
There it is, supply and demand. There's such a thing as called supply and demand, where if we got the supply, as in, you know, the manga, and it's lasting however long, then, you know, if the supply, if let's say 205 chapters isn't enough for you, if that supply ain't enough, well, guess what? The demand, especially if it's really, really good, is gonna fucking skyrocket. So, with that in mind, even if Demon Slayer is supposed to be ending, give it a few years. Because my formula, like I was trying to say, is that with anything, if you even if it's planned, but you don't, you know, publicize that to the public, right? You don't let that bit of information go out, right? Let's say I'm gonna use Naruto for example. Let's say Kishimoto decided, like, he knew that he was gonna end Naruto the way he was gonna end it, but also he was going to expand the universe a little bit more with Boruto, right? The formula goes as this: okay, do Naruto the way you want, right? Finish it out, you know, have the anime adaptation, have the movies, all that kind of thing. But then you just let it be finished, right? Let it be finished. Give it at least 3 years. 3 years tops. Anything beyond that, people are gonna start going fucking crazy, like Dragon Ball and Bleach fans. Okay, you don't want people going into cardiac arrest. You don't want people going to the hospital fucking freaking out over this shit. Okay, so 3 years is healthy. 3 years is a good enough time to where the demand will continuously keep going and going and going. Because then you don't want to give people doubt. Because when you give people doubt, then, you know, then you have a bunch of mixed things. Then you have then that breeds assholes online, where they'll be like, dude, it's never coming back, blah blah blah. Like, you're gonna get people like that, and those people are just fucking annoying as it is, right? So you give it some time off. The creator, they can, you know, enjoy their families, you know, do other things, maybe like drop some little teases, do some sketches of characters and whatnot, and then boom, big surprise, or not to the publisher at least, but or to the studio behind, whatever. But yeah, then they come out with whatever sequel it is. So it's like, I really think like anything has potential. Like anything that has any type of real, what do you call that? Like real popularity in some way, shape, or form. Like, and to be honest, I'm waiting for, me personally, I'm waiting for a Fist of the North Star, like either a remake or a sequel, because that shit, that IP is very popular in Japan to this day. Like, when I was there 2 years ago, I was walking by mad arcade machines, like of pachinko, that was Fist of the North Star. I'm like, why are they using Fist of the North Star? Why? Because it's popular. People fucking know it. They are familiar with it. You know, Hokuto no Ken. Like, you know, like everybody knows that shit. Okay, so as far as Demon Slayer is concerned, you know, I think that, you know, read the manga, see how it ends for yourself, you know, support the anime, support the movie, support everything that's gonna be coming, because I can tell you guys right now, there's already a mobile game that's about to happen. I signed up for it. even though it's like all Japan, there's like no inclination that's gonna be in English yet. And then there's gonna be an actual like home console game coming like next year, which is gonna be freaking dope. And yeah, like, you know, like we're gonna have the movie this year, we're gonna have the season 2 presumably next year, so there's plenty of Demon Slayer to go around. But aside from the Demon Slayer, wow, we talked about a lot of things besides Dragon Ball on this podcast.
We went, you know, full power out of control for a little bit.
Yeah, but that's totally cool. I enjoy doing that. This is the nice liberty that I enjoy having on something like this, where we take the title of this podcast and we literally exercise it.
It's brand great. It.
Exactly. Full power, we're out of control. But nonetheless, today's main topic, pretty much one of the only topics today, unless you know, we come up with something on the fly here that kind of just works, which normally does. Sometimes it happens, but that being that Toyotaro and the gang released some rough drafts to kind of tease and get people excited for the upcoming Dragon Ball Super Chapter 60. Dragon Ball Super Manga Chapter 60. So it's like a few images. I feel like they gave us a lot.
They gave us a lot.
Yeah. So if we're going to be talking about this, right? So this is, like I said, this is off the official Dragon Ball website. So this is open to the public. It's a Japanese site for the most part, but you know, if you're using Google Chrome, you know, on that good tech, you have that John Auto Translate, and it works pretty well for the most part. So I'm gonna read this to you guys real quick. What the note that was left for these sketches, rough drafts, all that kind of thing. So the manga Dragon Ball Super serialized in V-Jump. We will release the name drawn by Mr. Toyotaro for a limited time. Check out the beginning of the 60 episodes that will be posted in the July issue of V-Jump released on Thursday, May 21st. In episode 59 of the latest episode, Goku and Moro, who fought the selflessness of Trillion, fought fiercely. Remember, this is Google Translate, right? Goku declared that he would challenge with full power against Moro, whose power is still invisible. The name of invisible. 60 episodes. Yeah, you're right. the name of 60 episodes. I'm gonna guess is Mirus's miscalculation. So yes. Mirus's miscalculation is gonna be the title of chapter 60, which makes the fight between them even more intense. Is here. All right. So, first image. Let me zoom in on this image right here so I can see it clearer. All right. The first image that we see is like a standoff between Goku and Moro. Goku still looks like he's in his Ullman in Ultra Instinct state. We have some dialogue going back and forth between Mirus and Whis. And, you know, as the title, you know, basically reveals to us, Mirus' miscalculation. So, Kai, what exactly do you think this miscalculation is about?
I have two theories.
Okay.
My first theory before I saw Mirus' face in that panel was that maybe he underestimated how much of Ultra Instinct Goku would actually be able to control. Because all right. We all know how Goku works. He taps into a form once, he taps into it twice, boom, mastered.
Right.
That's Goku logic. And he'll take that and he'll expand it and he'll go even further beyond the end. He'll go plus ultra.
Oh, God.
He'll go plus ultra instinct. There we go. Branded.
Plus ultra in... Yo. Stop. Oh, my God. Please continue.
But yeah. So that was my first thing. But now I'm looking at this, right? Now I'm looking at this panel, and it's making me wonder, like, Mirus's face, like, man's looks kind of stressed, right? And... Mm. I know these are sketches. I am aware that these are sketches. And in sketches, they don't like to do tedious things like coloring Goku's hair in. However, with that being said, I'd like to point out the fact that Mirus was not really supposed to be doing anything with Goku in the first place because
facts.
Angels are supposed to stay out of shit.
Facts.
What if his miscalculation was thinking that he could help Goku just a little bit as long as he wasn't fighting? Because Whis, once again, does not look happy.
Facts. This is going off the first image.
Just going off of one image.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's good. That's a good deduction. Pretty much 100% agree.
Because, like, regardless of how strong Goku's getting, Whis's face is not pleasant.
Yeah, because Whis looks like he still has that face like, you motherfucker, you shouldn't have even been helping. Yeah. So the next, moving on to the next image, because yeah, I already agree, there's really nothing for me to add. But next image, we see Goku powering up, we see Mirus kind of, looks like he's also powering up, and then the double shot of them literally looking like in unison. They're just holding that X button or something, and they're just
holding that X button.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, this is a straight this is a straightforward shot. And this is literally my pre-kindergarten Japanese memory with the little bit of knowledge that I know as far as reading Japanese goes. I can actually read what Goku is saying, and I can 100,000% confirm to you that those characters actually read.
Yeah.
That's sure. A ha followed by a bunch of ahs, all right? Those A's.
It's a ha, and then Moro's got the
yo. Dude, I gotta get back to my Japanese lessons. But yes, so that those little bits that I do remember, bro. That's crazy. Yo, I technically just read my first panel ever. Wow.
He said technically I just read my first panel.
Yo, for real.
Guys, you gotta hear first of out of control reading.
Yes, out of control reading featuring Uchi and Kai, bro. This is the most real shit ever. So yeah, so they're powering up in this next one.
You got the menacing,
yes.
At the bottom, like when they're on the X.
All right. So that's two out of however. I didn't even count. Then the third image is just it's like a wide shot of like their power kind of exploding, right? So
yeah.
So it looks
sheer
like
essence is clashing.
Right. So, you know, just like, you know, in regular Dragon Ball fashion, when we have these moments occur, you know, this is pretty easy to imagine for those that haven't seen these images. But if you're, I will try to. I know that for Spotify, Apple Podcast listeners, I'm not really sure if there's any kind of description that you guys can click on. So I definitely highly recommend checking out the video version of this, so that way you can 100% be able to see all of the supporting links in the description, as well as anything that we might reference in during an episode. So like for this example, like this link will be there for you guys to click, so you could check these images out for yourself. Because again, like I said, this is off the official Dragon Ball website, and these are not leaks by any means, which I guess I should also bring this up really quick. I might actually start doing leak content, because you know it's just more things to talk about, more things to speculate on, and yeah, so it just brings more conversation to the table. But anyway, let's continue. So yeah, so like I said, page three, there's still like, it's just, you know, more, it's a wider shot. We have like a kind of like a bird's eye view in the one panel, and then the second one in between, they have like you said, the two essences clashing, like their ki is just like overflowing or whatever. And then like again, another wide shot even further back on the third panel of this page right here. So there's this page has three panels right here, and they're like, you know, they're powering up. So really not much else to add outside of that. So when we go to page four that they're sharing, and I'm not really sure if this is in any particular order. I don't know if this is like literally like how it's going to show up, you know, when we read the new chapter.
I think it is.
It might be. Like, this is a super dope preview.
Yeah. This isn't a preview anymore. This is a spoiler.
Yeah, right. Well, that's the thing. If they're putting it in front of us, it's technically not a spoiler.
You already know how Dragon Ball do. They literally spoil it in the titles.
Dude, they spoil it in the titles. They spoil it in the video. No. True spoiler, I don't care what, if it's fucking promotional or not, is when they put the characters that don't even happen yet in the video games first before.
Oh my god.
Dude, it is, and I'm so glad I did not play Xenoverse then, and I'm so glad that I didn't see that shit when they revealed it, because Ultra Instinct literally happened. Well, mastered, I should say.
Yeah, mastered happened. Ultra Instinct released on Xenoverse 2 like three nights before the episode of his debut, where we even got to see what he fucking looked like. We knew he had white hair because of Xenoverse 2.
Yeah, that's fucked up, man. I'm so glad I did not see that shit. So glad. But yeah, for the reaction's sake.
Everybody was theorizing that he was gonna like fuse like some shit like with Kaioken or whatever to be his final form. Like when that first image leaked and he had the black hair with like it was like the back shot, no shirt.
Oh yeah.
He had like the red aura. That was it. They were like, "Yo, is that Kaioken with something?"
Yeah. Yep. I never forget that. Fans will take any bit of clue to make it into something. I was too. I was like, "Yo, he got mixed aura."
Yeah, oh, yo, shit. Goku with the mix-ups in his transformations.
Yo, my man got the Kool-Aid in his shit. But, alright, so page 4. Again, another stare down. This is more of a close-up to each of their faces. More grunting, I can guess. And then we have a shot of the other Z Warriors. I see 17, 18. I see Jacko. I see Piccolo. I see Gohan. And then we have like some dialogue from Gohan and Piccolo, and it looks like
not get thrown back.
I know, right? That's crazy. I mean, I feel like he Respect. Probably will. Yeah,
he probably
he's,
will.
he's holding his own for the time being. But and then we see some close-up shots of Goku's feet. It looks like he's, or is that Goku's
they're,
feet?
Yeah, that's Goku's feet. He's walking they're walking towards each other. They're stepping up.
Ah, so.
It says
okay,
square
cool.
up, bro. They're getting closer and closer with those energies.
Okay. So. So, yeah, so they are, okay, so, yeah, you go to page 5, and page 5, they are, Goku is literally trying to approach Moro. Moro's also doing the same thing. Ooh, that's such a sick shot, the last panel. So, panel 4 out of 4 in this page 5, they're literally, like, about to be, like, right up to each other's freaking faces. Like, they're so close up. Again, the key shots, the essences, the auras are clashing in the middle of each other, and the menacing freaking John right below it. It's like you could feel the raw energy coming out of these guys. And then page 6, close up of Goku, close up, even closer up of Goku, and he just like he just yells that shit out in front of Moro's face, and Moro actually gets pushed back. By the time you look at the next few panels, Moro, you see a surprise shot of Moro. Moro actually gets pushed back. Don't know if that's him getting pushed back or if that's him just retreating.
Nah, that's him retreating.
Okay, so you think that's him retreating. Okay.
I definitely think that's, like, the way they drew that flight, like, you see him flying back, like, the way Piccolo and Gohan are looking at him, that looks like him retreating with his own energy.
Ah, right, so you're looking at page 7, so the next page 7, good transition. My man Moro out here flying high. Gohan, he must be saying at this part, he's like, oh, man, Dad probably got him to freaking...
Him back.
Yeah! So he pushed him back, but Moro, as the villain that he is, he's loading up that big energy ball, looking like a death ball
for
Frieza.
Looking like the death ball, I was gonna say that.
Yeah, looking like the death ball.
Goku's like, I seen that shit 30 years ago.
So Goku's on the prowl right now. He's not giving him no space. Shout outs to these sketches, even though these are like fucking rough drafts. Like, dude,
these are some tough rough drafts.
They're so, I love them. They're so talented. Like Toyotaro, God bless.
God bless, dude.
Page 7. So page 8. Boom. Oh shit. So Goku literally, it looks like he kicked the freaking death ball out of Moro's hand. And then hits him with a quick elbow to the gut there.
He kicked the ball and then he elbowed him. He literally hit Moro with the 1-2.
Hit him with the 1-2. No biscuit. Damn. Nice shit. And then Goku again on the follow-up. So after that elbow drop, or not the elbow drop, excuse me, the elbow shove, he literally follows up his attack with, you know, another approach. And then... page 9, knees him in the in the gut though. Oh, and he's bringing him right back to the earth.
Oh no,
man.
He straight kicked him. His
That is a kick. Yeah,
his
whole
foot is through him. Like, yes. I mean, it's not as bad as what 17 did to Piccolo. Like, God bless Piccolo's stomach regen. But like,
right, regen genes. Yeah, dude,
you
this
can
is sick.
See Moro's stomach is kicked in though. Like,
yes. Dude, good shit. Well, actually, right at the very last panel, yeah, he does grab him off. So, and that is the last of the teases. So, out of like the 40 to 42 pages that we get per chapter every month for Dragon Ball Super, we got a nine-page look
like, not even a tease. Like, this was straight up the first 9 pages of the next chapter of Dragon Ball Super manga. And the last part that they write in, the editor, I guess, writes, can Goku beat Moro and his Vegeta on the Yardrat star in time for the fight? I'm guessing the Yardrat star is, like, maybe the... his ride. Funny enough, why is he taking a ride? I don't know. Maybe that's they're low key.
They gonna give him some Kirby shit.
They're low key, literally deconfirming. They're giving him
his own Nimbus.
Yo, but they're deconfirming instant. They're deconfirming instant transmission.
They are deconfirming. I mean, yeah, they are deconfirming.
It is they literally, like, as soon as you say Kirby shit, it makes perfect sense. Yardrat star, Kirby rides on a star. Right, man. Whatever. But anyway.
Wait a second. So can we talk about that last page? Do you see something interesting? I mean, maybe my eyes deceive me because it's a sketch. I'm trying to zoom in as much as I can, but like...
Oh.
He grabs his foot.
Yeah.
And then Goku's like shocked. Not so much because he grabbed his foot. Did he shove it back in his stomach?
Nah, I don't think so because... So the order and how you're supposed to look at these from right to left, he like grabs his, you see the shot of Moro grabbing his foot, then you see the shot of Goku like being like alarmed or surprised or whatever.
Oh, I thought he already grabbed it in the top one. That's why.
Nah. In the top one, he got rocked.
Yeah, he got
to the solar plexus. He freaking got rocked to the fucking like the rock the dragon, right? So
yeah, Goku. Oh my god.
All right, so then the last part here of this editor note, you can read the rest of this in the V July oversized issue. Look forward to the release date. 12th volume of Jump Comics Dragon Ball Super, where warriors of the earth fight a hot battle against Moro Core, is now on sale. So, and then of course they reveal, you know, where you can buy
it. I'm sorry, I need to fix that Google translation. This says 12th volume of Jump Comics Dragon Ball Super, where warriors of Earth fight a hot battle against the Super Galactic
Adventure Patrol. Yes, that's a lot better. It sounds like Moro Core, like, fuck out of here.
Super Galactic Adventure Patrol.
Yeah. Yeah, so there you go, guys. That's the entire preview. 9 pages out of like the 40 to 42. Like I said, that's normally the average that we get every month since it is a monthly. And dude, this is a sick little look into what exactly we're gonna be getting. So you know what? I'm actually looking forward to reading this even more now that we saw this, because I'm curious to see if what our predictions with the dialogue itself matched up. Like, with the conversation, the little conversations that happened, obviously the grunting, screaming. I know that 100%. I can say that I read my first Japanese page out of a manga and I understood what the fuck was going on.
How is that possible? You're able to read that, but you literally just caught up with the Demon Slayer manga. You couldn't read one scream in there?
Well, see, everything in that was translated, so, you know. All the ha's were ha's in English.
All the ha's were ha's.
Yeah, dude. That's how it goes, but
better than Waz being Waz.
I'm really looking forward to this nonetheless. Chapter 60. Okay, again, they're teasing Vegeta like normal, right? Is he gonna appear in this one? I know from last episode you don't want him to, because you want his triumphant return to be as epic as possible, and I totally agree with that.
Debut. He gonna pull up on that star like a throne.
I really do hope that really doesn't deconfirm instant transmission, because
it really better not. They're like, that's such a useful technique to have, and like Vegeta always relying on Goku. He don't want to fucking hold Goku's hand for that shit. Why don't you just teach yourself, you stubborn ass?
Oh, but you know, here's a thought. What if the reason why he's not using instant transmission is
because of his pride?
No, fuck the pride. I think he's starting to outgrow it a little bit. Like, he does. He's definitely very prideful.
He would not be in those yard rat clothes if he hadn't started to outgrow it.
Exactly. That is what I was about to say. But with as far as this particular situation, if we're taking this hint as, oh, like, he's either the deer confirming instant transmission, or there's another reason why he's taking some kind of a ride. He's using a ride service to to get back to Earth. Maybe it's because he's still trying to he's still trying to like finish whatever he's trying to finish, and he's like doing it on the go. Like he's doing takeout at the same time. You know what I'm saying? Like, and for whatever reason, he doesn't want to use old instant transmission because of, like, he wants to be like 100%, like, what, the second he steps foot on Earth. That's just a thought, I guess. But I don't know. What do you think about that?
I feel the same. I just want Vegeta to have his moment, you know? Like, this fight's already lit, especially, like, it's Dragon Ball.
Right. It is.
That's all I can say.
Yeah, I mean, you know, Goku has plenty of plenty of time to shine. You know, it's been, I mean, for crying out loud, this man has had his moments in Dragon Ball. He's had his moments in Z. He's had his moments in GT. He's had his moments in Super. He's had lots of moments. This man has a resume full of them. Vegeta can barely get any as it is. You know, facts. The moments that he gets are really meaningful. Nah,
like, Goku gets moments, but Vegeta gets frames.
Yo, that's... I understand that so well, but that, like, totally undermines Vegeta so hard. Like,
I'm not trying to. I'm just spitting facts.
Oh, my God. Like, okay, well, I will say this. The episode where he admits that Goku is better than him when they fought Kid Buu, still one of my favorite episodes of all time. Yep. I wouldn't say that's frames. And I would definitely
But that's not like okay. He's had moments or whatever, but the moments he's had aren't relating to the end of the universe or anything. Like, you know, they're not relating to the fight. They're all like inner moments that he's having to grow as a character, which is amazing.
Yeah.
Vegeta deserves a fucking award for best character development at this point.
My man Chris Sabat, who voices him, even said, like, he's like, dude, Vegeta is the best character in Dragon Ball. He's the most grown. And the whole audience applauded that shit. It was so fun.
Most grown.
Yeah, he's the most grown, I guess, yeah. Damn. But another thing, like, yo, you can't say Blue Gatorade Diamond against freaking Jiren was frames. That shit was so dope.
Okay, you're right. And you know what else was dope? Goku versus Vegeta was dope. The OG.
Oof.
You know what else was dope?
What?
Vegeta standing up to Frieza. That was dope.
Yeah.
Vegeta standing up to Cell with that final flash. Said, okay, take this. Take this to the face. Or are you a bitch? That was dope. Majin Vegeta, every frame was dope.
Every
real shit. Every frame of Majin Vegeta was dope. But you know what the problem is? All those end with a L.
Therefore, it is like 20 frames per second.
Deadass.
Oh man, why? Why it gotta be like this?
I'm just saying, his moments are bound towards him growing as a character. Because if you count his moments in actual combat, they are there because he is part of the main squad of the show. He is a Z fighter in and out, and they gotta give some shine to some people, especially because they need somebody to fight while they wait for the hero to arrive. Get the fuck out of here, headass. Give Vegeta some shine. Let him take the W. Y'all should not have taken that from him when he was trying to kill Frieza in the Frieza movie.
Facts.
He should have been the one to put Frieza down. Period. Yes. That should not have gone any other way.
Yeah, no. That's the one character you definitely should have given that shit to Vegeta.
Like, that's what I'm saying, too. Like, Goku had a moment. Goku had a movie. Goku had the whole movie in there. Vegeta had a frame. He got the hit. He literally hit Vegeta with the 1-2. He hit him with a bop him, sock him. And then what? And then also, Frieza blew up everything. And then they redid it, and he didn't even get that shine.
Dude, also, Vegeta had the big surprise shock moment too. No one thought he was gonna have Super Saiyan Blue, and then he whipped that shit out, and that shit was fire.
Exactly.
It was such a nice surprise. And yo, when I saw it for a second time with Brother Uch, and like I said, second time, he didn't see it the first time, I was like, yo, just be ready, because he saw the poster, he saw Goku Super Saiyan Blue, he's like, what the fuck? He's like, he got another power up, right? And so of course you see Goku doing it, and you know how Brother Uchi is, fucking this guy, he's like he's getting warmed up, he's fucking like he's smiling, he's fucking shaking his hands, he's like doing one of these, you know, he's getting ready, right? And then as soon as he's like, all right, Vegeta's like, it's my turn, and Frieza's like, you know, he's like doing the whole pompous thing. And as soon as Vegeta starts, like, going, yo, I look over to Brandon, bro, and he's like, wait, what? his whole shit dropped. And he was like, oh, he's like, Vegeta too? Like, it was awesome. It was awesome. It was perfect. It didn't even matter. He didn't even ask how. He was like, yo, this is godlike. I was like, of course.
I stand by my statement, as I always have. Anything Goku can do, Vegeta can do 3 months later.
Dude, as you say that, I will never forget. I will never forget this meme. What? Where it was the episode when it was right after where Goku surprises us and brings back Kaioken, and that literally the next day I go online and I see a meme where it's Vegeta on Google how to use Kaioken.
Yep.
Oh shit, that shit was hilarious. But you know what? Here's the best part though about this situation. Well, one of the best, a few things. One thing I could definitely say, that if Vegeta does get the W, the big W, he is the one that solidifies it, and he's the one that gets the win. There's no bullshit. There's no strings attached. There's no like team up. None of that. Okay.
That'd be like the first win he got since like what? Zarbon?
Wow. Damn, really? It's been that long? I guess,
like,
you're right.
I could be wrong, but like, I'm trying to think. Because like, when you think about it, like, Frieza was a dub. Cell was a dub. Majin Buu was a dub. Mm-hmm. Battle of Gods was a dub. Frieza was a dub. They gave it to us because we wanted Vegeta to have a moment. We're like, oh, he skipped red. He went to blue. Oh, he killed Frieza. Undo.
Undo. Right. They undid it.
So like, give this man a W. Like, he's, oh my god, most overgrown character. Like, everything about Vegeta is fire, and they just do him dirty.
Dude, honestly, this is,
don't
like,
give him a, don't give him his panel, give him his chapter.
Give him his chapter. But listen, this shit, as long as it happens, and it happens right, this will solidify Toyotaro's career. People will literally make a statue out of Toyotaro and put it right next to Toriyama. They will literally, like, immortalize this guy and be like, yes, Toyotaro is the one that made sure that we got Vegeta that W, son. And then the other thing I wanted to say, oh shit, I forgot what I was gonna say. Damn. There was a few things. The Toyotaro thing, there was something else that I wanted to add to this whole thing that had something to do with Vegeta, obviously, but if it comes back to me, I'll bring it up.
But yeah, but I just want Vegeta to have his, you know, have his thing. He deserves it more than anybody else.
Yeah. No, it's so like, true.
Everybody hands L's to Vegeta all the time, and it's so depressing because he really put the work in. He really, like, you know, like, and I mean,
I remember what I was going to say now.
You want to talk about Vegeta getting disrespected? Who disrespected Vegeta the most? Who do you, in a fight, who do you think disrespected Vegeta the most?
I would say Frieza. Or wait, well, it's either Frieza or it's the time where Goku did not use Super Saiyan 3 against him when he was Majin.
Okay, hold up. I didn't think about that. The answer might actually be Goku.
Yeah, because
goddamn,
Goku literally Goku held back.
Yeah, yikes. All right, so
he did not want to use his newest addition. But what I was going to say before I forget was the other thing, in addition to the Toyota Taro thing, was that this could be, this could literally be, you know how big this moment will be for Vegeta? He will come through with whatever new techniques that he got from Yardrat, right? And if he does actually defeat Moro with whatever he's got, this literally will totally outshine Goku in such a way where, like, Goku's literally using Ultra Instinct. This is a form that Vegeta has no access to right now. And
this is a form that nobody has access to right now.
Yo, but think about it. He literally, if Vegeta defeats Moro without Ultra Instinct, that's just gonna make him look that much better. And it's gonna really have people questioning how good Ultra Instinct actually is. Well, it's very, very good, obviously. But obviously, against someone like Moro, who is all about, you know, life and energy consumption, it's proven otherwise. It's proven like it's just like every other form. And last chapter, man, that shit made me feel like it was like on some Super Saiyan 3 shit. Where it's like, oh, stamina, here we go. Super Saiyan 3, 2. Fuck.
They've been saying that about the blue form too. They've especially been saying that about blue with Kaioken on top of it. They're all about this stamina shit because it's a way for them to say, oh yeah. So it's a way for them to explain why their hair color changed back to normal.
It's so annoying. It's the problem. This is like one of the many problems with Dragon Ball.
He ran out of stamina. Bopped. And then like two frames later, goes right back.
What happens when they run out of all the colors in the rainbow? Like, if we even get to that point, which I hope we don't. Like, I hope the only other kind of color variations we get is if, like, it's, like, similar to, like, a Goku Black situation. Where it's the same... Yeah, like, that was
unique.
Yeah, it's a unique color, not like, oh, here's Super Saiyan Orange. Or here's Super Saiyan freaking Green.
I can't forget when we were watching that Kefla, that Super Saiyan Sparkly.
Super Saiyan Sparkly. No, I don't want none of that shit. He was saying purple. Like, what is it? Green, orange, purple are the only ones they haven't used yet.
They used green.
No, listen. That's unique. That is unique.
Yeah. Yo, all right. Sick. That's why people have it too, right?
Yeah. That's unique because, like, because you want to go there? All right, bet.
He's
What about Kefla? Oh, yeah? What about Gogeta Super Saiyan 4? Why is that shit red? Super Saiyan God, that shit's red. Oh, but is Gogeta Super Saiyan God? Or is he Super Saiyan 4? Is he Super Saiyan?
Obviously Super Saiyan Sparkly. Weren't you watching it?
I'm done. Conversation's over. That conversation came and went. Holy shit. Oh, my God. I want to rewatch GT so I can become upset.
So I can become upset?
Yeah, so I can watch that fight. And watch the episode where Gogeta is fighting for all of 5 minutes and then they...
Oh, I know, right?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
But, yeah, so... Anything else you want to add?
You got me upset.
Oh. But, yeah, anything else you wanted to add to this before we acknowledge some of the comments from last episode?
Stop handing Vegeta L's.
Please.
Give him supply and demand, right? Supply Vegeta some W's. Come on, guys.
Yeah, imagine if he wins this shit and then, like, the preceding arcs after this, like, it's literally just Vegeta, Vegeta, Vegeta.
It's the Vegeta show.
It's the Vegeta, Gita, Gita, G, Vegeta show. That should be godlike. And then...
Did you really just... I did.
100%. I'm owning it. But, yeah.
Oh, my God.
Imagine if that, like, but think about this, ready? If that was to happen, Vegeta, like, becomes, like, this fucking, like, he is the new hero, right? He is the new number one. And Goku, like, this would, I feel like the only other acceptable thing that I would take preceding Moro, unless it's them just going to the end of Z, which we're all waiting for, right? Is if Goku is like, hey, Vegeta, we haven't had a one-on-one in a while. Why don't we settle this one more time? And Vegeta wins that fight. Dude.
That's too much to ask for. I'm gonna keep it real with you. I'm gonna keep it so real with you. You know why? Because we had,
it'd be too good.
They tease us, like, they hold that shit over our heads for our whole lives. Like, in all of Z, we had it teased in Super between, like, them sparring 25-9 and then all these power level comparisons and all these transformation power level comparisons. And then you have the dumb shit, like, Gugeta versus Goku. And then you have Goku Black versus Vegeta, who wish, that's a nice transition back to what I was thinking before you said, when Goku held back Super Saiyan 3, because that is the most disrespectful shit he ever had, Vegeta ever had done to him. But I was talking about, like, in a fight, like, yeah, like, what was the most thing that I could think of before you said that was, like, Goku Black literally stabbed this man within 3 seconds of him flying up.
Oh, shit. Yeah, that's true.
He literally, he like, Vegeta flew up, got some cute hits in. That shit felt like a plush pillow. Goku Black literally whooped out the Keyblade, the God Blade, stabbed him, said, "You're an appetizer. Feed me. Good night. Itadakimasu." Actually, no. Technically, Vegeta was cooked. So, gochi sou sama.
Oh, show you. Oishi desu.
Oishi.
Oh, fuck. Damn.
So this is what I'm saying. Like, we gotten teased with that shit all the time, and every time, same shit happened.
But, hey, it lines up with all the teases. Like, imagine if this is how they truly want to end, like, to close Super off.
That goes back to my point of saying, like, Goku gets moments, but Vegeta gets frames. Like, Vegeta really got a frame against Goku Black. And then what? He went in the hyperbolic time chamber, was told not to blow it up, blew it up, and then came back. Then he came back, went to fight Goku Black, got his hits in, declared himself as Vegeta-sama. And then what happened? Goku Black smiled and put both of those two down together by himself with his arms crossed.
I'm telling you, this is the new age Vegeta, bro. I'm telling you, this we could potentially be on the cusp.
We need a new age Vegeta. I mean, seeing him in Yardak clothes, kicking and punching the same way Goku does, that had me feeling stressed, because it might just be like, I don't even know.
I'm telling you, dude. I'm telling you, we could potentially be on the cusp of new age Vegeta, bro. Where this is like, it's almost gonna feel like a shift in protagonists, to be honest, because, like, Goku's always going to be the character that he is. I don't see him ever really changing as far as, like, you know, at a character level with his, like, just the way he is. Like, he's been for a very, very long time. And even with a guy like Vegeta, who used to be his enemy and now is obviously, like, arguably one of his close friends, I guess, because, you know, they train together, their families are family friends and together, and they've fought a lot of battles together. Like, they have grown close in that regard. And so seeing Vegeta be the one that ultimately takes over or defeats Moro would be so amazing, and it would open up Goku's eyes in such a way where it's like, it's not that Goku's ever doubted him to be strong, but because Goku's always trying to become stronger always, and that's just literally how people can say Goku's so
essence.
It's to say in essence, true, but it would literally, like, get that conversation started. Or it goes this way. I feel like this is almost fated to happen, because, like, this is how you truly write Vegeta as, like, a serious, like, it's not just about Goku no more. Like, they got two number ones in a sense, right?
Okay, see, like, real quick, like, hold that thought. The only reason I don't think there's gonna be two number ones in Dragon Ball times is because they, like, I feel like in Toriyama's eyes, you know, like, someone who, like, barely wanted to keep going with this in the first place, he tried to shift the protagonist and everybody, like, gave him shit for it. So he's like, oh, you want the same one? All right, here, take the same one. You know what I mean?
I understand that, but you know what though? I truly feel like it's a new age, it's a new time, because I see mad people online saying, we want Vegeta. And listen, the way Dragon Ball works is, like, things can change tomorrow. Things can literally be like, we could understand something now, and then we'll really learn about it. They can hit us
with the
actually. Yeah, that's 100% Dragon Ball. That's how that shit works. And I truly feel like if once Moro's done, Vegeta gets the W, whether it's Goku challenging him or it's the way the arc ends, is Vegeta looks at Goku and he goes, Kakarot, like, it's been a while since we've actually had a one-on-one fight. And they even shout you out by saying, they reference all the times where it's like mock-up fights against each other, like him versus Goku Black, Goku versus the Vegeta slime, like all those things, right? Like he mentions all those things, and then it's like, you know, once we're well rested, I would like to actually have a one-on-one fight against you. And then Goku's like, of course, he's like, accepts it or whatever, right? It goes either of those two ways. They have this grand fight. This fight, this is the cherry on top. This is how you end Super. This is how you go into End of Z. You have Goku versus Vegeta, the rematch that everybody's been waiting for, and you have Vegeta win. And you want to know how you have Vegeta win? You don't have him win because, oh, he's using his Yardrat abilities. You don't have Goku win or lose because he exhausted his Ultra Instinct and or whatever other fucking Super Saiyan shit he might want to try and use out, pull out, whatever. You know how you do it? They exhaust everything first. They obviously go hard. They don't give up nothing. But it gets to the point where they don't even have enough in them to use Super Saiyan. So what do they have to go back to? Basics. They then give us an all-out fight, like Dragon Ball style. The shit that a lot of people are also missing. The part of the series that people that really feel like Dragon Ball is still like the greatest thing ever. Like, that is one of the things that people will hold on to, because Dragon Ball has a lot of amazing fights. And if they did that in here now, in the current modern era, 2020, do you know how many... Dude, this shit would literally be, like, one of the best things to happen in the whole franchise right there. Where it was literally just all... It became... It wasn't about no tricks, no power-ups. Like, they go through all the power-ups, they go through all the tricks... But it comes down to a point where it's just like they got nothing else left, and they have to it's all down to just like almost like a world tournament style kind of fight where it's just fists and kicks, no bullshit, right? That would be amazing. And if Vegeta wins even at that point, then boom, you have literally rectified and completely like resolved all the issues that they've ever had with the show, with Vegeta, with Goku, and they can then proceed to the end of Z and beyond with that amazing taste in everyone's mouth. That is fucking how you do that shit. That's what I would love to see.
Well said.
Bet. So that's an agreement out of Kai. That's how I know I did my job. Like, imagine that shit, though. Dude.
Well said.
Oh, shit. That was crazy. All right. Oh, fuck. I just realized something.
Added 30 more minutes.
Yo, I fucking actually just really realized something. Okay, well, this is where I'm going
to... Do we need to hold that? Do we need to hold that for next time?
Honestly...
Is it one of those...
Okay, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna put a timer on.
Nah, we can't, bro. You know damn well we can't do that.
Hold on. I'm gonna put a timer on, and this honestly, after
this
everything,
means he's about to say some shit that's about to get me riled up.
I'm gonna give us 10 minutes. Listen, I'm gonna give us 10 minutes, okay?
Nah, son.
I have to save it for next time. Because think about it. Next time, next episode is literally all it's gonna be about that chapter. Yeah. So here is another thing that once I finish saying what I'm gonna say, I'm gonna hit this timer. then you're gonna respond, and then we're gonna go from there for the remaining 10 minutes, and then that's it, okay? So, you know what? Before we even do that, let me just acknowledge the comments really quick, because I don't, like, after this shit, we're done. Like, that's it, okay? Really quick, boom. We got 3 comments to acknowledge.
Oh, wait. Oh, yeah. Didn't we have comments from the 14 as well?
I don't think we did, but I can.
Okay.
I can pull that up, though.
Give me one. That's fine.
I can pull it up really quick just to make sure. Let me see that. Episode 14. This. We had 15 last week. Here it is. Comments. Oh, yeah. It was just suggestions. Like, a bunch of shit. So, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to save the episode 14 comments for 16. Or, I'm sorry, for 17. Because it's going to be... This is a lot to cover. It's a lot to cover.
Okay.
All right, so last week's comments, right? We have someone that says, damn, the fuck happened? You died. Nope, we're still alive. We're glad to be back. The second one. All right. And last but not least, we got a topic suggestion. Topic, use it if you want. But me and my friend talked about it. You can talk about how different DBZ would be if Krillin ignored Goku in the Saiyan saga and killed Vegeta. I think it would be an interesting topic for the podcast, like a what if story. I kind of disagree. That doesn't really make sense. Not gonna lie. Krillin ignoring Goku, I mean, that's it to me. It really just sounds like one of those like really, really, really silly what if moments you'd find out of a video game. And even that,
I mean, it holds merit though, because like when you think about it, like when you think about that moment, like Krillin really was about to stab the shit out of Vegeta and just end it right there, considering all things that had happened. And Goku was the one that was like, hey, don't do that. Let the bad man live. And in reality, like, that doesn't make logical sense, but...
It's not in Krillin's character, though. That's the thing.
Like, exactly.
Like, that's why I'm saying, like, that's like a...
Exactly.
That's a stretch in itself, because he, like, they have... like, what do you call it? Like, that's something that I would expect to see out of a video game what-ifs thing. If they ran out of ideas, like other what if, like better what if scenarios. But I mean, hey, it is what it is. Like, I'm sure there are probably other people that might think it's interesting. But like I said, like, I look at, like, you'd have to then tell me, what if Krillin was a different kind of person and then bring this in? I feel like if you even had to go that far to just kind of get a better answer out of us. Yeah, like, it just adds to the stretch that it already is. Like, if you have to elongate the stretch that is already a stretch, it's gonna fall apart, is I guess what I'm also trying to say. But do you like Attack on Titan, Dragon Ball Super, Dr. Stone, Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood? Well, those are just a few of the several different hundreds of anime selections that you can watch for free with my trial code for Funimation Now. All you gotta do is click that link in the description below and check out Funimation Now for a free 14-day trial period to enjoy all of these anime and many, many more. That's Funimation Now by using the link in the description below. But yeah, that's pretty much all of the comments, right? So, all right, here it is. So here's the rule, ready? You have to let me finish when everything that I'm about to say.
Oh God, I'm gonna mute myself. You so can, I can do that.
Well, you okay? Well, okay. I can limit you to you can let
reactions,
out yes,
but not
yes.
Okay, I feel you. We're on the same vibe. Go ahead.
Okay, I recently learned of another possible outcome that could happen, that could involve Majin Buu.
I'm uncomfortable.
And this, I will give full credit to where I heard this from. This is, of course, from Geekdom's channel. Geekdom had one of his artist friends who did the thumbnail for this particular video for him. And the topic was about how Majin Buu could still be involved. And this is something I literally did not think of. And this is something that I honestly don't know if I still want to happen after this whole podcast episode went by and we talked about everything with Vegeta and how we, you know, things like how in a perfect world, how everything would line up and all that kind of stuff, even going forward. I kind of don't want this, what I'm about to say, to happen. But have to bring this up, because next week's episode is most definitely going to be about the chapter 60. So with that in mind, this outcome involves Vegeta being back, Goku obviously being there, them fusing, and Boo absorbing them.
Nah.
So there goes the timer. So now you can feel free to say whatever.
All right, my whole like thought process on that, like that idea, right? No.
Now what's crazy is that the artist, they actually drew this shit actually like kind of dope. It was like Super Boo, but
Super Boo Gogeta absorbed.
Yo, but what Gogeta's clothes absorbed was like the Yardrat clothes, but over it was Goku's gi. Like, dude, it looked silly, but it was perfect at the same time. And I never thought of
but
it.
But like,
that
how
way.
Was it? It was like, but it was Majin Buu that absorbed him, right? So it's not Super Buu with the big banana. We got Fat Boy.
Well, no. For some reason, I mean, that's another thing. Well, no. Yeah. Because, you know, if he did
that's
absorb
a whole other thing.
If they, yeah, but if you think about it, if they absorbed, if Buu absorbed, I mean, we wouldn't know until Toyotaro draws it, like, cause. You would think like, oh yeah, well if he's Fat Boo, shouldn't the overall model stay fat? But yep. They could change that.
This is Dragon Ball. They can do whatever they want with that piece of bubblegum.
I think what realistically matters when it comes down to Boo's absorptions is like he takes on the figure more of the figure that he's absorbing. So like, you know, when he was. Like, when it was Kid Boo... Well, think about it. When it was Kid Boo that absorbed the Grand Dai Kaioshin back in the day, he took on the fat form that he has now. So...
Yes?
So, yeah. So, if you... So, like, think... of, like, let's say if he absorbed Goku right now. I feel like he would get the frame.
I see where you're going. I see where you're going with that. And with that logic behind it, it makes perfect sense. Can't front. Mm-hmm. My counter to it would be, and this is not a very strong counter, but I'm gonna say it anyway. What about when evil, like dark evil Boo, absorbed Fat Boo? He didn't get fat, he got pink.
That's true. That is true. That's the only.
And I know it's not a strong counter.
It's a light counter.
Like he absorbed himself, but like it's a light counter, you know, it's a parry.
Okay, think about it this way. That Boo, that dark evil Boo, the pure evil Boo. Was anorexic. My man had no meat on the bones. As soon as he absorbed Fat Boo, boom, he gained the muscle. Done. He was. If you think about it, that literally counters your counter, because that evil Boo, the dark chocolate Boo, that tastes like shit because milk chocolate is better. Okay, that Boo was so skinny. He looked like he was from a third world country. Okay.
He was so skinny, he looked like Gotenks fucked up the fusion again.
Yes, exactly. So by the time you absorb the Fat Boo, it's basically like he took all the fat and applied it to the muscles. And therefore Super Boo was born.
Take that logic out of life. So all I gotta do to get,
yeah, right.
get muscular is just be anorexic and then just eat everything.
Yes. Right, right, and exercise, of course, but yeah.
Don't try this at home, kids.
That's basically how that worked. So yeah, so I feel like if Boo did absorb, you know, Gogeta at this point, because this would be the first time we'd be seeing Gogeta like not in a movie, not in GT. It would be a nice surprise to have that happen. But I don't want it to happen. I will just put that out there again, because I just do want this to be solely focused on Vegeta just winning, right? I want that to happen 100%.
Yep.
But let's just, for the argument's sake, because we do have like 5 minutes of this open topic right now to just add it in, like the cherry on top for this episode, I will say that having a Super Boo Gogeta absorbed version would be very interesting, considering that we have a very new Vegeta in our hands with new skills and techniques at his disposal, and Goku with at least Omen under his belt for Ultra Instinct. So imagine,
right, that shit really is under his belt.
And that, exactly. So you fuse all that shit together in Boo's body, dude. That is a very strong being. Boo's already strong as it is. He's got magic of his own. But now he's got Vegeta's skills, Vegeta's new techniques. He's got Goku's you know, his Ultra Instinct Omen. And that's a done dizzle. I think that would be the most broken character, to be honest. Aside from Moro, you know, absorbing everyone's fucking life energy and shit. That would be interesting. That would be a good opponent for Broly.
I got a better question for you, and I feel like this is so off topic, but it's a quick one.
Okay.
Like, what do you think would be a more this could be a whole, like, I mean, this is not a what if. This is just a debate. This is just out there comments. Don't even take this seriously. Just relax.
Okay.
But what do you think would be a more powerful, like, fusion combination? A Saiyan and a Majin, or a Saiyan and an Arcosian, like the Frieza race?
I feel... Okay, so that's actually a great question, because...
You know what I mean? Like, they both have, like, insane things. Like, all three of those races.
So I think I honestly think that doing the Majin Buu would be stronger, and the reason why is because if you think of it in this way, right? Frieza came first in comparison, right? And throughout the story of, you know, Dragon Ball Z, at least, you always had, like, every big bad is supposedly stronger than the last.
Of course.
So with that in mind, Boo is at least like two times this as strong as Frieza would be. And Boo's been around for zillions of years. So
Boo came first.
By that regard, if you're talking time-wise, Boo did come first, but like, we didn't see Boo until when? Way after. They had to hold his ass for last.
Yep.
So I think that would be the case. Like, Frieza's the strongest shit. Like, they always, to this day, they're still like talking about Frieza and referencing Frieza. Like, cause yeah, like, see, you gotta give him credit.
That's my counter too. Like, that's my counter, is I wanna say the other one, right? Cause I feel like in a show like Dragon Ball, where everything is so power level based and so like strong heavy as a show, I feel like, how do I put this? Like, the Frieza fusion would be stronger infinitely. Okay. I take the opposite opinion on that. I think that the Frieza one would absolutely provide so much more of a benefit. However, I think that the Majin one would be more busted because just the pure, like, even if the Majin is losing the fight, the absorption techniques, the regeneration techniques, the magic healing techniques, like, all that shit, busted. Support status out the ass. But in a show like Dragon Ball, where at the end of the day, I mean, this Moro shit might really change stuff, so knock on wood. But at the end of the day, where, like, strength is what matters over all things, I feel like Frieza, the prodigy race that, like, literally reaches God status in a couple months, don't put that with Saiyan Cells.
Yeah, no, that's... I like your counter, because that just makes me want to see Frieza fight Boo, like, one-on-one.
Yo, Frieza fighting Boo, like, I feel like Frieza fighting Boo, Boo would win just because Frieza would get caught off guard on some cocky dumb shit. But if Frieza's elevated past the point, like, thanks to Tournament of Power and seeing Ultra Instinct, Frieza's gotten his eyes open plenty. Like, I hope he actually puts his ass to work and, like, does some damn push-ups this time around. Some mental push-ups this time around. Because Frieza is really, like, the best, like, one of the best villains Dragon Ball has to offer. Like, period.
He's one of the best. Actually,
it's Goku Black. but Frieza's definitely one of the best because, like, they need to give Frieza more development too. Like, I'm sick of Frieza. Like, I'm sick of Frieza going in underprepared, overwhelmed, and beaten.
He's going to go platinum, don't worry. Boo's going to be the one that's going to push him. He's going to push him to go platinum. He's going to go platinum.
And you know Frieza has magic too. Facts. Frieza is the avatar. Frieza earth bends. Frieza water bends. Like, Frieza got that shit on lock.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Now I can't unsee it. And on that note, watch this. Ready? Boom. That 10-minute timer.
I'm asleep.
Yo, that was perfect timing, though. That was great. And we got to fit all that other stuff in with Frieza. But that was a great question. That was a great add-on. But, yeah, I definitely... Ooh, I would love to see that fight, to be honest. I would love to see that shit. Maybe one day. That's not Super Dragon Ball Heroes or a video game outside of that, but...
I mean, honestly, if there's any place to see it, it might as well be Super Dragon Ball Heroes. They're already they might as well just put it in there and just give it to us.
No, because
it's not going to hold any merit anyway.
The thing is, I said this in my latest Super Dragon Ball Heroes video. I was like, man, I'm almost afraid to see anything cool happen in this show because that just, it's more likely that it'll never happen in the real show because it happens in here. Like, all of the Super Saiyan forms of these characters that have never gotten the light of day. Like, they basically deconfirmed us ever seeing Trunks as a Super Saiyan 3 or even a Super Saiyan God. He's a Super Saiyan God now. Can you believe that shit? Xeno Trunks is a fucking Super Saiyan God. Like, I'm done. I showed that shit to Brandon, dude. He was like, what the fuck? Like, he was, yo, if you ever want to see my brother conflicted, you show him anything out of Super Dragon Ball Heroes because... Yo, you literally, because he will, at his first instinctual instinct will be like hype, excited, and he'll be like, wait, is this Dragon Ball Heroes? And I'm like, yes. And he's like, fuck this.
Yeah, you get that?
He said, that shit's fake. Like, that's literally what he says. But, all right, that's it. We gave you guys a nice, hefty hour plus this week for episode 16. On Full Power Podcast. You guys have any other ideas or any kind of topic suggestions outside of the chapter reviews that we do, the coverage that we do outside, let us know in the comments below. If you have any if you want to reach out to us outside of the YouTube comments, definitely hit myself or Kai up on Twitter. You could use the hashtag AskFPP and also the hashtag Full Power Podcast. So that way we could definitely see it. And of course, make sure you tag us. We love, obviously you can tell, we love talking about all things Dragon Ball. This Full Power Podcast. And next week's episode will feature and center around chapter 60 Dragon Ball Super manga. That shit's going to be fire. And I'm actually thinking about releasing that episode early because I believe, as far as scheduling goes, the 20th, which is when that chapter releases, is going to be a Wednesday. So I would like to be nice for you guys as a little, I guess, gift or whatever, just because, right? And instead of doing the Friday releases like we normally do, I'll do my best to have that recorded, edited, and uploaded on all the platforms, at least the audio versions first. Some, like, last, this episode 15 gave me some problems because my program was not trying to, like, export the video version for whatever reason, so it was kind of a pain in the ass, but obviously, as you saw, it was eventually uploaded. So definitely look forward to next week's episode as well. Kai, you want to add anything else in as you're closing?
No, I'm good.
All right, dope. Well, all right, guys, keep it locked, loaded right here on Uchi Games channel. Keep it safe, stay clean, stay fresh, stay inside, take care of yourselves. May the power protect y'all. And we'll see y'all
next time.